sir, will be us.
Will your answer be yes?
Good morning.
Good
Happy
morning.
Sunday. Happy Sunday to everyone. To everyone. Congratulations to our new overseer, Pastor Calvin H. Handler. What a nice
Amen.
and
Amen.
warm and wonderful service on yesterday. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you over and over again. It was really nice to be a part of that, and I just want to say to everyone that it is a wonderful day. We are so blessed that we woke up to see another day, to
Amen.
see another moment, another hour, and as I always say, another opportunity to get it right.
Amen.
Another opportunity to get it right. So, hey, happy Sunday to everyone. Happy Veterans Day. It's coming up tomorrow. We salute you, veterans. We salute you. We honor you. And listen, I have to say, not only do we honor our veterans, but we honor the families of our veterans too, because they
Amen.
served right along with our veterans so many times. They served right along with them. So to you too, it's a day to celebrate for you too, not only for our veterans, but to the families of our veterans. We celebrate you too. We don't want to leave anybody out. So
Amen.
we celebrate you as well. Let us just pray. Our kind and most gracious Father, we thank you. We thank you for this day. We
Yes.
thank you for this second Sunday in November. We don't have very many days left to this year, 2024. So, Father God, we thank you for this day. Father God, we thank you because you kept us this week. This has been a very difficult week for everybody. It's been hard. It's been tough. It's been one kind of those weeks that you say, Lord, Lord, you just call on his name. Sometimes you don't even know what to say. You're just, I can only speak for myself. And it has been a very traumatizing week for me. And I just want to let everybody know that it's okay to feel what you feel. Don't let anybody tell you you shouldn't feel what you feel. Yes, we understand and we know that God is in control. We get
Yes.
that. But
I'm on it.
sometimes it might take us just a moment, just a minute, just an hour, just a day, just a week, just a month
Yes,
to get to
sister.
where we're supposed to get. And it's
Amen.
okay.
Yes,
It's okay.
hallelujah. That's right.
Black women, I
That's okay.
salute you.
Hallelujah.
Black men, I salute you.
Thank you.
I salute you
Yes,
because
sir.
it's been difficult for us. I don't
Yes.
care what nobody says.
I'm on
I know
now.
God is in control because if he wasn't, I would not be here today.
Hallelujah. Yes,
I
but
would not be here today because I thought my heart was going to break. But oh God, we thank you for your love, for your mercy, for your
Yes, Lord.
grace and
Yes,
your kindness,
Lord.
and
Yes,
even
Lord.
for your understanding
Hallelujah.
that we're not okay right now.
Okay.
But you
Yeah.
got us and you're going to keep us
Well.
and you're going to lead us and you're going to
Yes,
guide
Lord.
us. You're going to protect us. You're going to
Thank you.
love us through our
Yeah.
hurt. You're going to love us through our broken heart. And for that, God, we thank you.
Thank you.
We thank you because you saw fit
So,
to elevate
yes, sir.
Calvin,
Yes, Lord.
our pastor, our leader.
Thank you,
You
Jesus.
saw fit. And we thank you for that.
Thank you.
We thank you.
Yes.
And it was a pleasure and an honor to be in your presence and be in the presence of the people that elevated.
Yes.
Thank you, Father, for that. Father God, we ask that you continue to bless us and you keep us, that you continue to watch over us, that you give Calvin a word to say to us today, that you continue to watch over each and every person here and their families. In these things I pray. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to move
Amen.
right into our hymn, our morning hymn this morning. And wash me over again.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Wash me over again.
Wash me over again. Wash. You know, God is just so good. He's so good that he can do things again. Okay. So he can wash us over again.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
Amen. Amen.
We're going to move on Amen. In our service, and we're going to have our scripture reading by my very own sister, Yvonne Fleming, and prayer by my brother, Keith. What a pleasure it was to see you yesterday, my brother.
It was good to see you, Sister Leslie. Amen.
It was
Amen.
A pleasure to see you.
Always.
So we're going to have... scripture by Sister Yvonne, followed by prayer by Brother Keith.
Amen. Good morning. Good morning, Remnant.
Good morning.
And congratulations, Reverend Overseer Designate. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. Amen. I'm so proud of you. I'm very excited for you. And I pray that Godspeed be with you and that you do everything that God has purposed in your heart. Amen. I just have to say that before I read the word this morning. But thanks God for the word. It's coming this morning from Psalm 51, I will read from verse 1 through 7. That is Psalm 51, 1 through 7. Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according to the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquities, O God, and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee, thee only have I sinned and done this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest, and be clear when thou judgest. Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, thou desirest truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part thou shalt make me to know wisdom. Purge me with hyssop, O God, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. This is the word of the Lord. Glory be unto the Lord. The word is already blessed. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Wash me over, O Lord.
Yes.
Wash me over. Hallelujah. 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 Let us pray. Heavenly Father, once again, we are thanking you, Lord, for life. Thanking you for life, more bountiful, life worth living. We thank you, Lord. We are thanking you. We are thanking you for the expansion of territories. Heavenly Father, we are thanking you for your mercy. Lord, as the sister said, we have some heavy and burdened hearts, Heavenly Father.
Yes.
But Lord, we know that through it all, God will, God is, hallelujah, and God did.
Yes.
Lord, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you on this morning, Heavenly Father, as we are commemorating our veterans, thanking them for their lives of service, Heavenly Father, for protecting us and our families, all those members of our families and those of our brothers and our sisters who have been in the service, Heavenly Father, as we step up ourselves and say, Lord, we are glad to be in your service. Use us, Lord. Hallelujah. Wash us over. On yesterday, we saw the pouring over of the oil, Heavenly Father. So anoint us. Anoint us afresh. Anoint us anew on this morning, Heavenly Father. Line us up and get us ready for service. This is roll call.
Yes,
and we are ready to do the work, Heavenly Father. We are ready to do what it takes so that we can build the kingdom, build the community, Heavenly Father, that will protect those that are weak, protect those that are meek, Heavenly Father, all those that are under your power and your will, Heavenly Father. We ask all those that are united in this circle, all those that are on their way, those that are on YouTube and Facebook, that are under the sound of my weak voice, Heavenly Father, that you prop them up on every leaning side, sustain them, Heavenly Father, give them healing. We claim wholeness, Heavenly Father. We claim everything according to your perfect will, Heavenly Father. We ask that you continue to bless your manservant, Heavenly Father, the man of God, the overseer, Heavenly Father. Bless him, bless him, bless him, bless him, Heavenly Father. Continue to touch his heart, Heavenly Father, to touch his mind, Heavenly Father, to gird his mouth from all sinful speech, Heavenly Father, but to continue to put your word in his heart so that he can share it, Heavenly Father, with us and with your children, Heavenly Father. I thank you for all my brothers and my sisters who are on this line. Heavenly Father, continue to bless them, to enlarge their territories, Heavenly Father, to give them purpose, Heavenly Father, so that they can work in purpose, they can walk in purpose, so that they can do what you have put them forth to do. Give them the gifts of the Spirit, Heavenly Father. Fill them with the Holy Ghost on this morning, Heavenly Father. Fall fresh, Heavenly Father. Show up and show out like only you can. I ask these things in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sister Yvonne, and thank you, Brother Keith. Thank you, Sister Yvonne, for the scripture. Thank you, Brother Keith, for that warm prayer. And Right now, I'm going to call on my sister Brenda, who it was so nice to see yesterday. You give the best hugs, girl. You better say something.
I didn't hug you too tight.
Yeah, you give the best hugs. God bless you, my sister. Will you just welcome us this morning?
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for waking me up this morning so that I could welcome the people, the people that have come to hear the word from our overseer. And congratulations. So come on and join us and hear the word and hear the prayers and hear the scriptures and enjoy what God is telling you. Come one, come all, and thank you. Thank you, thank you. And bring someone next time too, okay? Thank you.
Thank you, Sister Brenda. Thank you for that warm welcome. Thank you. We are going to have our music ministry again?
Yep.
Our music ministry?
Yes, yes.
While we're waiting for our music ministry, I just want to say, the Remnant family, God bless you over and over again. Thank you for the work that you do, the prayers that you pray. Thank you, the things that you do beyond what you have to do. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Just give me a minute.
Oh, Brenda, you singing yes. This morning.
Betty. I would love to tell you what I think of Jesus, since I found in him a friend so strong and true. I would tell you how he changed my life completely. He did something that no other friend could do. No one ever cared for me like Jesus. There's no other friend so kind as he. No one else could take the sins and darkness from me. Oh, how much he cared for me. All my life was full of sin when Jesus found me. All my heart was full of misery and woe. Jesus placed his strong and loving arms about me. He led me in the way I ought to go. No one ever cared for me like Jesus. There's no other friend so kind as he. No one else could take the sins and darkness from me. Oh, how much he cared for me. Every day he comes to me with new assurance. More and more I understand his words of love. But I never know just why he came to save me. Till someday I see his blessed face above. No one ever cared for me like Jesus. There's no other friend so kind as he. No one ever could take sins and darkness from me. Oh, how much he cared for me. Amen. Amen.
And
amen.
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Will thank a man rob God? Yet ye have robbed me. But ye say, wherein have we robbed you? These in tithes and in offerings.
Yes.
The verse continues with the promise that if people will bring their tithes into the storehouse, God will bless them and open up the windows of heaven.
Amen.
As you, I always say, it's always better to give than to receive. So we're going to have the moment now to do what we can do. Ways to be a blessing to the Remnant Family Worship Center. We can worship through giving. That's an important part of the worship service. Worship through giving. God loves a cheerful giver. Yes. You know, he gives us so much, and it's definitely not begrudgingly when he gives it to us. So we must in turn do the same. We want to be like him. So we want to be cheerful givers as well. And you can do that through the through Giblify and through Cash App. I think that is that Cash App? The Remnant Family Service. I say to everyone, take a screenshot and you'll know exactly what to do and how you can give. And I want to thank you in advance for your giving.
Amen.
Thank you in advance for your giving. We appreciate you for your giving. So thank you, everyone. And I'm going to move forward with the announcements. There's always something going on with the Remnant family. We're always doing something. And it, sometimes it's quiet. Sometimes it's with a lot of noise, but we're always doing something. And one of the things, one of my favorite things that we do is we have prayer each and every weekday morning, Monday through Friday. We have prayer, and you can, the morning, we call it the morning manner, starts at 7:30 in the morning. And of course you can reach us at 339-209-4712. We would love to have you. It's a great way to start your day. It actually came in so handy this week when we were all struggling. So praying together and coming together was helpful. It was helpful to all of us. So join us each weekday morning. We would love to have you. So 7:30 in the morning, we're on the call and doing the week. We have a midweek recharge prayer on Wednesdays at 12 noon. You can reach us at that same number. You know, sometimes we call it hump day Wednesday when you just need some help getting over the hump. You need some help to get you to Thursday and Friday. And we have a midday prayer, just short, brief. It's not long at all. So sometimes if you're sitting at your desk or you're eating your lunch or you just need a recharge, we're here for you at 12 noon for prayer. Each midweek recharge prayer. So join us at 12 noon. We have Bible talk every Tuesday from 8 to 9 p.m. in our virtual sanctuary. You can meet us right here. And we just, we have conversations. It's not only Bible talk and Bible study, but it's Bible conversations and conversations that we need to have. So join us. Join us. You can reach us through social media, of course, Facebook, YouTube and Instagram. So you can meet us right there, talk to us right there, make a comment. We'll be happy to hear from you. And from Pastor C's death, that's Pastor Calvin to me, it made me cry, but it didn't make me quit. You will go through many ups and downs in life. You may cry yourself to sleep at night, but never forget you've been anointed with fresh oil. Therefore, your it is now that you are oily and can slip right out of it. Use your oil. Thank you, Pastor Calvin, for that. We needed that this week. He says, be blessed, be encouraged, and expect greater. And we do expect greater. We do. Also want to remind you of our Circle of Champions celebrating survivors November 16th from 12 to 4 p.m. You can get tickets are $60 in advance, $70 at the door. There will be, and we're honoring our very own Sister Brenda, a survivor, and we're asking you to come and join us at the Circle of Champions celebrating survivors. Join us in celebrating our incredible champion survivors, honoring their strength and their resilience. That is November 16th from 12 to 4 p.m. at Remsen Hall, 375 Remsen Avenue, Brooklyn, New York, 11212. And of course, there is an email address down there that you can contact. And we look forward to seeing you there. The Remnant Family Worship Center Incorporated, overseer Calvin A. Chandler, senior pastor, a Winter Wonderland toy drive on Saturday, December 21st at Middle School 35's educational campus. That's at 275 McDonough Street, Brooklyn, New York, 11233. Please join us. You know, Christmas is a time of giving, and especially to our children. We always want to make them feel special, loved, and thought about. They look forward to this time of the year. They start looking forward to this time of the year, December 26th. They're looking forward to the next Christmas. So all of us can participate, and we can help make this toy drive a success. Mm-hmm. I'm sure Reverend Calvin is going to say a little bit more about that. But, you know, each of us, we always try to do something for the kids for Christmas. Our neighbors' kids, our grandkids, the kids we know in the neighborhood, in the community. You know, Christmas is for children. That's what makes them excited. Some of us are putting up the tree already, so kids are getting excited already, okay? So I'm going to turn this over to my very own Pastor Calvin, Overseer Calvin. It's nice, has a nice little ring to it. God bless you again. And I'm going to turn this over to you. Have a wonderful Sunday, everyone.
You too.
Grace, mercy, and peace multiply to each and every one of you from God, our Father, the Lord Jesus Christ. It is another day journey. We are so glad about it, how God has kept us and blessed us all these days in 2024. Amen. We are excited for what God is doing in and through us. Amen. Thank you, Sister Leslie, for so eloquently navigating us to worship on this morning. And Sister Maureen, Sister Yvonne, Deacon Cyrus, and Missionary Cyrus, thank you, thank you, thank you. Wash me over again in your precious blood. Amen. We're just so happy that God washes us over again, that he is not a God of a second chance, but he is a God of another chance. Amen. Amen. Thank you to all those who have prayed for us and came out on yesterday for our Episcopal Investiture. We had a good time. Amen. At the Mount Sinai Church. Amen. Thank you to all of those who played a part in making yesterday a great success. We are humbled and honored for everyone who prayed, everyone who came and supported, and whatever you have done to make yesterday a success, I appreciate you from the bottom of my heart. Amen. We are just so excited to see what God is doing in our life. We're excited to see where God's going to take us. As our motto is, expect greater. I'm expecting even more, even higher heights and deeper depths. Why? Because eyes have not seen, ears has not heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man what we shall be. So we are forever grateful for each of you, all that you do to make the Remnant look good and make God look good. Amen. Next Saturday, we are going to meet up at Remsen Hall and support our sister Brenda Cyrus. Amen. On next week, I'm going to be late. I got three or four different events and the time overlap. Amen. But one of my sisters in ministry overseer, Tanisha Johnson Bynum, has her pastoral installation service, I said it right, on next Saturday. So I'm going to show my face there. Then I'll come across town to Sister Brenda. Then I have a birthday celebration right after that. And then another birthday celebration after that. Bless God. So pray for us as we attempt to keep all these engagements. Amen. But listen, ma'am and sir, I need your help. I need your support. Again, every year we make it our business to do community outreach. I love the fact, as Sister Leslie says, some stuff you hear about that we're doing and some stuff you don't hear about. I don't believe in broadcasting everything we do for the community because a lot of people are spectators and want to mind people's business. And it's not everyone's business what we do sometimes. Amen. I need your help that on Saturday, December 21st, we're going to have our Winter Wonderland. Our desire is to bless, I believe it's 150 families with toys of their choice at that. So we need your help. Our event coordinator has been driving me crazy, calling me every day, 2-3 times a day. What you doing? I'm like, where your children at in school? So what do you think I'm doing? Amen. But she is dedicated and has so much passion. I'm like, listen, here go the letterhead, here go my signature. Do what you do. Just leave me alone. I said, don't bother me until Tuesday. Bless God. But we're thankful for her and all that she is doing. We have already started purchasing toys. If you know of a decent and reasonable storage place, please let us know, for we have to have somewhere to store all these toys until the 21st. Amen. So that is another expense that we have to cover. So we also need your donations, amen, to help us make sure that this is a good event. We have a DJ for the event. We have a bounce house. We want to have hot chocolate and so much. We just want to be a blessing to the community on the 21st. So we need your help. We need you to come out. We need your support. And we need your donations. Amen. Amen. Yeah. Things cost. And ain't no event a success. Ain't no meeting a success unless the budget is met. Amen. Oh. This is a huge budget, bless God, but we believe God for what he's going to do in the lives of us and his people. And then on December 31st, the flyers should be up this week. We have watch night service. Amen. We are partnering with Deliverance Churches and Saint, I can't think of the name right now. But Pastor Bird, amen. The partner with her, we're coming together in one location, as Bishop Sam has said on yesterday. We're raffling off good gifts. I hope I win. Bless God. We have a raffle and good food. So you're going to come. We're going to feed you spiritually, and we're going to feed you naturally. We're going to have fun. We're going to laugh, and we're going to pray heaven down. Amen. At this service, we're going to come, we're going to have a good time in the Lord, and we're going to make the Lord pleased, and we're going to enjoy ourselves in fellowship. Amen. We're working on transportation for those who are in need. We have so much going on, but we want to make sure the saints are able to get to the house, and not just the saints, excuse me, but the saints and the ain'ts can get to the house, because if you make it to the house, I know you'll be all right. Amen. So mark your calendars. We're aiming to have it in Brooklyn, right on Fulton and Marcus Garvey, and what's that, Troop Albany or something like that, right in the middle of Bedford-Stuyvesant, around the corner from MS-35 Educational Campus. Amen. So govern yourself accordingly. There is a word from the Lord. Amen. Coming today, we're going to bless God. to hear what he has to say to his church. Amen. Amen. Listen, I love you. I appreciate you. And there's absolutely nothing you can do about it. Amen. Let us pray for Michael Lucas. His family has posted on Facebook that he has been missing since Monday. I believe it was Monday. Him and I spoke on Saturday. And then to see that he was missing on Monday. Amen. Let us pray for the family, his safe return. We believe God for a miracle, that God is covering him wherever he may be, whatever's going on. Amen. Let's pray for the Ming family. All this time, I did not realize that Sister Satora Ming, that was on our prayer list, we actually went to junior high school together. I was with Minister Whitley on yesterday. She drove me to Pennsylvania, and we were talking, and she went to high school with her, and we didn't realize that we both knew her. I said, well, we've been praying for her for a while. And I didn't know it was her. I was just praying for the saints, bless God. And we're praying for that family and all the other bereaved families. Amen. Amen. We know God can sustain them as they go through this holiday season without their loved one. Amen. So let us stay fervent in prayer. We are staying on the wall. The Bible says prayer without ceasing. Amen. So let us continue to pray for one another and make sure that we're covering each other in prayer. With all that's going on around us, we need prayer. Amen. And thank God.
Sanctuary. Sanctuary. whatever he wants me to be, I'll be just that. So I tell him, look for me.
For me.
What you want me to be.
What you want me to be.
Oh, mold me.
Mold me.
What you want me to be.
What you want me to be.
Say mold me.
Mold me.
Say what you want me to be.
What you want me to be.
Oh,
amen.
Yeah.
First Samuel chapter number 17.
Amen. Amen. Mm-hmm. To your will.
I'm gonna probably do more reading than preaching. So you got to stay with me. Amen. First Samuel chapter number 17. Starting at verse 4. We're gonna be jumping around the text. And there went out a champion out of the camp of the Philistines named Goliath of Gath, whose height was 6 cubits and a span, and he had a helmet of brass upon his head, and he was armed with a coat of mail, and the weight of the coat was 5,000 shekels of brass. And he had greaves of brass upon his legs and a target of brass between his shoulders. And the staff of his spear was like a weaver's beam. And his spear's head weighed 600 shekels of iron. And one bearing a shield went before him. Amen. Jump down to verse 33. And Saul said to David, thou art not able to go against this Philistine to fight him, for thou art but a youth, and he's a man of war from his youth. And David said unto Saul, thy servant keeps his father's sheep. And there came a lion and a bear and took a lamb out of the flock. And I went out after him and smote him and delivered it out of his mouth. And when he rose again, I caught him by the beard and smote him and slew him. Thy servant slew both lions and bears. And this uncircumcised Philistine shall be as one of them, seeing that he has defiled the armies of the living God. Verse 37, David said, moreover, the Lord that delivered me out of the paw of the lion and out of the paw of the bear, he will deliver me out of the hand of this Philistine. And Saul said unto David, go, and the Lord be with thee. And Saul armed David with his armor and put on his helmet of brass upon his head, and he also armed him with a coat of mail. And David girded his sword upon his armor, and essayed to go, for he had not proving it. And David said unto Saul, I cannot go with these, for I have not proven them. And David put them off, and he took his staff in his hand, and chose 5 smooth stones out of the brook, and put them in his shepherd's bag that he had, even in the scrip. And his sling was in his hand, and he drew nigh to the Philistines, jumped down to 30-45. And then said David to the Philistine, thou come to me with a sword, and with a spear, and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of armies of Israel, whom thou hast defiled. This day the Lord will deliver thee into my hand, and I will smite thee and take thine head from thee. I will give the carcass to the host, the carcass to the host of the Philistines this day, unto the fowls of the air and to the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel, and all this assembled shall know that the Lord has not saveth not with the sword and the spear, for the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you into our hands. And it came to pass, when the Philistines arose, he came and drew nigh to meet David, and David hasted and ran towards the army to meet the Philistines. And David put his hand in his bag, and took there hence a stone, and slung it, and smote the Philistine in the forehead, that the stone sunk into his head, and he fell upon the face of the earth. So David prevailed over the Philistine with a sling and a stone, and smote the Philistine and slew him. But there was no sword in hand of David. Therefore David ran and stood upon the Philistine and took his sword, drew it out, that he saith, therefore he slew him and cut off his head therefore. And when the Philistines saw that their champion was dead, they fled. The word of God for the people of God. So we say glory be unto God. Father God, we come and ask you to do it again. I've studied, but I need your strength. I prepared, but I need your power. God, I can't preach until you speak. So speak to us like you have done times before, but send the anointing for this preachment, God. Send the anointing to make preaching seem kind of easy. Lord, hide me behind the rugged cross so they may hear or see none of me, but only see and hear what you have to say to them. Let this word take fertile ground and root inside of them. In the mighty name of Jesus, we do pray. Amen. And thank God. Everyone in this life will face some kind of obstacle, some sort of problem, some situation in their life. And sometimes we're going to face some things that seems as if it's too big for them to handle. It could be a situation at work, in your family, or in your life that seems just so overwhelming that you just can't figure out how you're going to make it, how you're going to get through it. One thing about these giants is it doesn't matter how young you are, no matter how old you are, no matter how much money you have, how rich or how poor, these giants are going to show up in your life. Each and every one of us under the sound of my voice, with me included, are going to face some things in our life. But we must understand that if we have God, our God is bigger than whatever the situation is. Let's look at the text. According to the text, Goliath issued a challenge to the Israelites, daring them to send forth a champion to engage him in a single combat. Every day, twice a day, Goliath comes down and said, listen, send someone, let's fight. Goliath was bigger and taller than everyone else. He was fierce. He'd been battling all his life. He is a champion. He is the undisputed champion of the world. If he was in WWE, They say the Mosaic text notes that Goliath was 6 cubits and a span tall. That's about 9 feet and 9 inches tall. He wore a heavy armor. He carried a sword and a spear. But not only did he have the sword and a spear, and he had a large shield that he carried, but he also had an armor bearer going before him to make sure he don't get hit, and no one dared to fight him. But we see the shepherd boy named David, a young boy, if you will, who had the faith in the Lord. His older brothers were soldiers in Israel army. So one day, David's father said, Jesse said, listen, go down and take your brothers some lunch. I packed them a little lunch. Take them lunch. They're on the battlefield. They need to eat something. And when he arrives, he heard Goliath's challenge. Oh. David asked the soldiers why no one defended Israel. His brothers were angry and told him to go take care of the sheep. But David knew the Lord would defeat him. Can I pause right here for the first time in the Sunday school lesson to be careful who you listen to? There's going to be people who are going to look at you and think you don't qualify to do the job. People are going to look at you and think that you're not the right fit to do the job. But if God has called you to do it, beloved, no demon in hell, ain't nobody on this earth can stop you from doing what God told you to do. Yeah, let me get on this express room. The Bible says that King Saul knew of David's faith, so he asked to see David. David told Saul that he was not afraid to fight Goliath. David explained that once he was looking after his father's sheep, and a lion showed up and took one, and a bear showed up to take one, and the Lord had protected him, and David was able to save the sheep and fight off the lion and the bear. David was able to overcome and kill the lion and the bear to protect his father's sheep. Saul said, all right, but David said, wait a minute, before I go, what do I get? What do I get for slaying this Philistine? Sometimes you have to know what you're getting for doing some of the things you do. What's the benefit package that's tied to it? Saul told him that listen here, take my armor and go and fight, because we know the Lord will protect. Can I pause right here for a second time in the Sunday school? Let me stop the train and tell you, be careful of the ones who want to dress you in their armor. Be careful of the ones who want you to look like them. Beloved, Saul was a fighter. He had all these people in his army, but no one wanted to go. But now David said, hey, I will go. But now he want to put you in his armor. Saul's armor was fit for Saul. You have to make sure that what you have on and what you're doing fits you. You can't wear someone else's garments into battle. Why? Because it won't fit you appropriately. I worked at the school. The NYPD sent out a memo to all school safety agents saying they had to wear bulletproof vests. I found it very interesting that the only people that wear bulletproof vests is the school safety agents. What about the rest of us? But that's beside the point. They said they all had to go to 1PP and get measured for this bulletproof vest. Why? Because these bulletproof vests are tailored made to fit each individual agent. Therefore, if agent one wanted to use agent two bulletproof vest, it won't fit right. Why? Because we come in all different shapes and sizes. Some are tall, some are short, some are big, some are small. You have to make sure that your armor fits you. You have to make sure that you are walking in the anointing God gave you. If you're not anointed to usher, baby, sit your happy heads down. Don't usher. If you're not anointed to sing, don't try to get up and sing so low. Beloved, you have to make sure you're doing whatever you're doing, it fits you. Another thing why David couldn't wear Saul's armor is because if he went in Saul's armor, everybody would have assumed and thought that it was Saul fighting the battle. Don't try to be like no one else. Don't try to dress like no one else. You have to be the best you that you can be. Whatever God has called you to do, you have to do it. And don't worry about anybody else, but just do what God has called you to do. David says, I cannot wear this, for it hasn't been proven by me. I haven't worked in this. I don't know this. I have to be comfortable. On yesterday, if you was at the investiture, you seen the live, you noticed that we both had purple cassocks on, and we both had garments on, but they were different. Her garment was made for her, and my garment was made for me. Bless God, my garment was tailored made. I had to go there several times to make sure it fit and fit appropriately. And no matter how much my garment looked good, my garment would not have fit Overseer Collins, and her garment definitely wouldn't fit me. You have to be dressed in your anointing that God has given you and not no one else. You got to make sure your armor fits. When David takes off Saul's armor, and he said, listen, I got this. Because when I fought the bear, I didn't have a sword. When I fought the lion, I didn't have all this armor. All I had was all the armor I need. Because I had the Lord protection. The Lord protection that covers me. When Goliath saw David, he shouted and made fun of him. He said, a shepherd boy could not beat him. David shouted back and said that he trusted in the Lord to protect him. David said he would beat Goliath and show the Lord's greatness. Can I park the train right here in the yard? We're done now, y'all. I gotta go. You have to be able to stand in whatever you face and let them know that the God inside of you can handle every situation. You're going to find obstacles. You're going to find things in your life. You're going to come against some situations and realize that it's big. Yes, it looks like you can't do it, but beloved, you can't do it on your own, but you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. You're protected. Why? Because the Bible says no weapon formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue that rises against you in judgment shall be condemned. They laughed at him. They mocked him. They said he wouldn't win. He's just a young boy. But can I pause right here and tell you, as we get off the train, is that God doesn't call the qualified, but he qualified the call. If God sent you to do something, it doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter how much money is in your bank account. It doesn't matter how many degrees or letters behind your name. All you have to do is walk in the authority God has given you. The Bible says David ran toward Goliath. He took a smooth stone out of his bag, and he put it in his slingshot, and he hit Goliath in the head. What I find interesting is, with all the armor that was on Goliath, with the armor bearer in front of him, he had to hit it with so much power that it went through all, and the Bible lets us know that Goliath fell to his death. And not only did he fall to his death, but then the young boy David went and took off his head, just like he promised. When God has equipped you to do a job or to do a task, you must go and do it with all your might. Don't get caught up in the foolishness of what others are going to say. They may going to talk about you. They're going to scandalize your name, but I come to tell you that if God be for you, who can be against you? I came to tell you that if God told you to do it, baby, just do it. Don't worry about how it's going to get done. Don't worry about what things look like. Don't worry about nothing. Just walk in the reality of a done thing. But you have to make sure your armor fits. You have to make sure it's for you, because what God has for you, it is for you. And beloved, if you try to be somewhere else, you will fail every time. God has made you different on purpose. God has ordained you to do a specific thing on purpose. So, beloved, I come to encourage you on today to make sure the armor fits. Make sure the oil fits. Listen, I like the fact that We did our elevation together. Why? Because we pulled strength from each other. And as I was working on the documents and things for the service, I was able to send it to Overseer Collins, and she was able to send back ideas and thoughts. We make a good team. You have to make sure your team is there to encourage you and to push you into your purpose. You shouldn't be connected to nobody that's going to hinder you, but you need people in your life that's going to push you, that's going to encourage you, not give you their armor, but make sure you're equipped and able to handle what God has you to do. Beloved, that's all I have for you on today. You may want to know, how can you get in contact? How can you make this connection with one that's able to allow you to slay lions and bears? How can you get the strength to be able to slew your Goliath? It's as simple as ABC. Admit that you have sinned, believe in Jesus Christ, and confess that Jesus is Lord. And the Bible says, Book of Romans teaches us that you shall be saved. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, I will turn from heaven and heal the land. We got to do our part, and then God will do his part. Let us pray this prayer together. Dear Lord Jesus, I know that I am a sinner, and I'm asking for your forgiveness. I believe that you died on the old rugged cross for my sins and rose from the dead with all power in your hands. I turn from my sinful ways, and I ask you to come into my life and to come into my heart. I confess you as my Lord and Savior, and I will follow you as my Christ and King. In Jesus' name, amen. If you have done your ABCs today and you have prayed this prayer with us and you have accepted Christ, let me be the first to say congratulations on making the best decision of your life. You are now saved. Reach out to us. We want to hear from you. We want to pray with you. We want to pray for you. You can give us a call. You can even text message us, 646-287-8972. You can email us, theremnantfwc@gmail.com. Hop in our DM, our inbox. We will be glad to hear from you and to pray with you and for you. Amen. Just make sure whatever you're doing, that your anointing, it fits you. Amen. Don't try to be no one else. Bishop Sampson, like this yesterday, be you. I can't be Dr. Whitney. I can't be Apostle Wiley. I can't even be Bishop Sam, but I can be the best overseer chandler that God has called me to be. God has anointed me to do a work that only I can do. Amen. Overseer Collins, God has anointed her to do a work that only she can do. Yes, we're both overseers. Yes, we're both working on the same ministry, on the same battlefield. But amen, she has been called to different assignment than I have. So we can help each other, but we can't be each other. Amen. And thank God, that's all we have for you on this Sunday. Again, it is our prayer that you are blessed, that you are encouraged, and that you are expecting greater. Why? Because God has greater in store for you. This is not the end of your story, but it's just a turning of a page. Amen. So walk in the calling that God has given you. Walk in the reality of a done thing, knowing that God is going to heal, set free, and deliver. Believe God for what you want him to do in your life, and act like it's already done. Amen. God, we thank you for this time that you have given us to share this word with your people. God, we pray even now that you would touch each and every one of them on the sound of my voice, whether watching on Facebook or whether watching on YouTube or even in our virtual sanctuary. God, we pray even now that you will bless, heal, set free, and deliver. Now, kind Father, do what you do best and be our Father. See about your children. And now unto him who calls the sun true by day, the moon true by night, the only wise God, our Savior, be all glory, majesty, domain, and power, both now and forevermore. And we all said, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Peace.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Happy Sunday.
Happy Sunday. Rabbi, I sent something in the chat. Are we still doing the Thanksgiving baskets?